Welcome. In this video, we will discuss about the performance of Beti Bachao and Beti Padhao scheme. So this is again one of the flagship scheme of the present government and is basically dealt with how our society as a whole can move towards a more gender equal society. So which is again for your examination, just remember it is also part of the sustainable development goal which India is also trying to achieve. So gender equality is one of the sustainable development goal, and India also we are trying to achieve a country, a society where we are talking more about the gender equality and decreasing the gap or filling the gap of the gender inequality. So Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao is a very important initiative in this regard. So we will discuss about what is the Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao scheme is all about. And after that, we will also see like this year, it was like the 6 years since it was launched. So it was launched in 2015 at the date of National Girl Child Day, which is celebrated on 14th Jan. So just a trivia information for you to remember that 14th Jan is celebrated as National Girl Child Day. So for that information, this is this year, now it's going to be the 6 years since the Beti Padhao, Beti Bachao scheme was launched. And in that regard, it makes sense that we kind of have a report card how things have worked out after this initiative came into picture. So let's start, let's try to understand. First of all, what are the major objective of this particular scheme? So the prevention of gender-based sex selective elimination. So you must have heard of India as one of the country where female infanticide was very common. Like back in the days, it was like the sonography actually has to be banned because people were going for sex selective termination of pregnancy, or they were even going for the feticide where they are like, once they figure out that it is a girl child, they are killing it. So in order, this particular Beti Bachao comes from that component that we have to save the girl child because the child sex ratio in India was really dwindling. Ensuring survival and protection of the girl child. Ensuring education and participation of the girl child. So now this is also a very important component, that not only survival, that is important, like when a girl child is infant, the survival is at most priority, but later in life, education is also very important so that the girl of become empowered. So women empowerment is also something which is start very early in life itself. So education play a very major role in that. So in that regard, again, and ensuring education is also one of the major objective of Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao scheme. Protecting the rights of girl child, again, all the rights which are extended to the male child or to the boy child, same rights should be given to the girl child. That's the whole idea of gender equality. This also lead to the multi-sectoral nationwide campaign. So like BBP is a national campaign and focused multi-sectoral action in 100 selected district. Low in child sex ratio covering all state and UT. So basically child sex ratio is nothing but at the time of birth, how many girls are born as compared to boys. So that is how the child sex ratio is determined, girls as compared to or in like total population of boy. So if we say that the child sex ratio is 900 to 1000, it means for 1000 boys there are only 900 girls. So this is the idea of child sex ratio. In that regard, the Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao Andolan was actually started, and that too is not like every district was earmarked and started with the campaign. It was started for the 100 district. It is a joint initiative of Ministry of Women and Child Development, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, as well as Ministry of HRD, which is now known as Ministry of Education. So these three ministries, if you really look at it, you will need the neonatal care and all the malnutrition related information from the Health and Family Welfare. You definitely need involvement of women and child development, and definitely education is also one of the important sector from where the women empowerment could take place. So in that regard, Ministry of Education, Ministry of Family Welfare and Health, and as well as Ministry of Women and Child Development, they all converge their resources to actually start this scheme. So this is something you should remember. Now let's let's move forward and look at the performance, like how the performance has been for the various section over here. So if you look at over here, the sex ratio at birth. So what has been determined that after the launch of the Beti Bachao Beti Padhao scheme, the sex ratio at birth has improved 16 points from 918 in 2014-15 to 934 in 2019-20. Now this is something I will really implore the aspirants that this slide is really important. Make a note somewhere. This data you can definitely put in when you are writing your essays related to women empowerment, or you are writing any question related to social justice or women empowerment. You can quote this kind of figure. So this is something you should remember, that from 2014-15 to 2019-20, we were able to make 16 points gain in terms of sex ratio at birth. How about the health? Then ANC registration, which is the antenatal care. This has also increased, like when a woman is pregnant, how much access women is getting to the medical services and all the other care facility is what is recorded under the ANC registration. So that has also increased from the 61% in 2014-15 to 71% in 2019-20. So it means again 10% increase can be seen in the ANC registration. Also, institutional deliveries, which means that the pregnant women are delivering the child in case of a institution and not at home and going through the unhygienic or unsanitary means. So again, institutional delivery has also increased. So the percentage of institutional deliveries has shown improving trend from 87% in 2014-15 to 94% in 2019-20. So again, this has also improved. Now let's just look at the concept of education. So we've gone through that sex ratio at birth has improved. We have also seen how the health indicators or the facilities availed by pregnant women has been going on well after this scheme. Now let's just look at the education sector also. So gross enrollment ratio, basically how many child who are in the age group of going to school are attending the school, is what is your child gross enrollment ratio. So GER of the girls in the school of secondary level has improved from 77.45 to 81.32. Now again, you don't have to exactly remember, you can just say that from around 78% to 81% increase have happened in the time period of 6 years when after the scheme was launched. So again, this is good, and you have to remember we are talking about the secondary level, which has been a lot of issue, like people were able to send their daughters to the primary education, but there were a lot of dropout at the secondary level. So this improvement is again something which means that the going forward, the childs are getting more equal opportunities. Now, there is also an interesting data that the percentage of a school with functional separate toilets for girls have shown improvement from 92% to 95%. Now, this is considered as a major reason why the girl child were not allowed or were dropping out after the primary education, because the physical requirement like the menstruation cycle and all this thing would require the girls to have a separate washroom there in the school, which was not the case, and that is why this increase will eventually lead to a decrease in the dropout rate of the girl student. Then there is also a factor of attitudinal change. So this scheme has been able to bring the focus on important issue of female infanticide, lack of education amongst girls, and deprivation of their rights on a life cycle continuum. So it's not like they are being denied the rights at the birth or when they are child. Even after marriage, they have been denied right. Even when they give birth to the child, again, it's a continuum cycle where they never get a relief. So this particular Beti Batao Beti Padhao Andolan was also about that, how this kind of behavioral change could be induced in the people. Beti Janmotsav is one of the key programs celebrated in each district. So basically, whenever a girl child is born, it's kind of a celebration which gets into the rolling in the particular district, so that again the awareness, the attitudinal change could also be there. So these are the certain performance. So from the look of it, it's looked like this scheme has been successful, and there have lots of strike meet been made in various sector, but again a lot also need to be done. So this is something about the performance of Beti Bachao Beti Padhao scheme. Now let's just quickly look at the other things which again government is doing. So one is the Ujjwala scheme. So basically, don't confuse it with the Ujjwala scheme, which is for the LPG connection. So that is for your LPG connection. This one is for the trafficking, the women who have been suffering from the trafficking, human trafficking racket. So to tackle the problem of trafficking, it is a comprehensive scheme for prevention of trafficking and rescue, rehabilitation and reintegration of victim of trafficking for commercial sexual exploitation. So basically what this scheme does, that under this scheme, the women who have been exploited in the human trafficking system, they would be provided with the rescue, they would be rehabilitated, and they will also be given the scope to reskill themselves so they can sustain themselves. So again, this is very important to kind of reintegrate them again with the society. There is also a Kishore Health Card, which is to record the information about the weight, height, BMI of adolescent girls. These health cards for adolescent girls are maintained at the Anganwadi center. So this is again something like you need to have the information. That is why you must know that we need to keep on having the health checkup so that we know how our body is reacting. So in that regard, Kishore Health Card will help to see whether there is any deficiency which could be like really important at the growth age. Then there is also a scheme for adults and girls which talk about how the anemia could be treated and how the other components of nutrition could be treated. Then there is also Sukanya Samriddhi Yojana, which talks about saving accounts in the name of girls so that that could be saved for their education. So this money could be saved for their education. All these things are the other initiative which has been taken by the government to protect the girl child, to promote the women empowerment. All these things are taken into consideration. So again, remember the name of these schemes and the basic ideas so that you can again quote them when you are writing answers. So I hope you have understood this video. If you have any doubt, feel free to drop a comment. Thank you.